Practice set 2, problem number 1, found on page 5. Find the median for each list of numbers. To find the median for a group of data, we first need to put the data in order. Sometimes they call this ranked, from highest to lowest or lowest to highest. Then we'll find the middle number in this ordered list of data. So for the first set of numbers, we can use a procedure called a stem plot to help us organize our numbers. Since we're running from numbers in the 60s through the 90s, our stem is going to be 6, 7, 8, 9 for the numbers in 60s through the 90s. And we'll just go through the list. 88 goes along in the 80s. 89, we'll put a 9. These are known as the leaf values, the second value. 76, here's our 70, we'll put a 6. Next is 65, we'll put a 5. Next number is an 80, 9, so we put a 9. 90, and again another 90, we'll put the 0, that 1's portion of that. 84 is in the 80 category, and 87. It's organized them within the tens, and now we can go through and set up our values in order from smallest to largest. We put it back together. The smallest value we had was 65. The next was 76. 80 requires a little bit of sorting. Our smallest value is 84. The next value would be the 87, followed by 88, and 2 89s. Next, we jump to our 90s, and we had 2 90 values. The number of values that we have, we need to count them up. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 values here. And to find the middle, we can do this one of two ways. We can calculate it. What's the halfway or the middle? If I take the number of numbers and divide it by 2, I get the 4.5 position, which I'm going to round to the 5th position. So if I start at the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or if I start at the top, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the middle value, the median for this set of data is 88. Sometimes when this is introduced in lower elementary classrooms, they'll have students starting by crossing out the largest and the smallest and working their way into the middle value. And there's our 88 for the median value. The next set of numbers that they want us to find the median, they're all pretty close to one another. I can just pick the smallest and work our way through the list. 21, the next smallest would be 23. We have 2 25s, next largest would be 30. We have a 35, a 45, and a 48. You'd want to make sure that you haven't missed anything and that you do have them in numerical order. In this example, we have 2, 4, 6, 8 values. And if I use the same procedure I did in the last one, 8 divided by 2 means our middle is an exact value of 4. There are 4 below the middle and 4 above the middle. So our median is falling in between two numbers, and to calculate the median, we average the numbers on either side of that middle point. So we'll take 25 plus 30 and divide that sum by 2. Well, when you add 25 and 30, you get a 55 divided by 2, which ends up with a median of 27.5. This isn't part of the data, but it is the correct procedure when you have an even number of data that you're determining the median for. The other part of problem number 1 has the following data. Same thing, we have to put our data in ranked or numerical order. So the smallest value is 0. Even though it's a 0, it is a number and should be included. We have a 7, an 8, a couple 9s, followed by 3 10s. Looking for that median value, which is the middle, if we use the approach of just crossing them out, starting with the smallest and largest, and moving in closer and closer to the middle, this one is an even set of data where the middle is in between those two values. We have 4 below and 4 above. So when there's an even number of data values to determine the median, we average the numbers that are on either side of the middle point. In this case, they're both the same value. And no surprise, when we average them, 18 divided by 2, we end up with a median value of 9.